As you're putting one of these birds together, there's a lot of moving pieces. And this needs to turn very freely. This is the driven gear. In other words, the motor is turning that wheel or that gear. So that needs to move very freely. The more difficult is the bird. Trying to get everything to turn freely on this. And the problem's going to be right here. At least in my case, the problem is there. Getting those connecting rods to move freely on those balls. And these ball and socket joints are a little difficult to loosen up. I take the hex shaft that connects these two body wheels, and I just gently put that in a chuck, put the con rod on there, and I'm using corn oil. I just take the dental applicator, and I put a drop of corn oil on there, and just run it in. If you're doing this dry, you don't want to go very fast because you'll generate enough friction, you'll melt that PLA. So we just want that to where it's going to loosen up and it will come off of there fairly easy and then snap on there and stay on there. On this end for the wing, about all you can do is put one on here and just wiggle it back and forth and try to get it to loosen up while it's attached here on the wing. This runs pretty slow. So after this goes back and forth 1,000 times or so, hopefully that'll loosen up and it will move more freely. One thing I have changed, all the fasteners are printed at 100% infill. And on my printer, 0.12 millimeter layer. And I go back and on the fragile places, like these tend to break off either right at the thread or where the head, I go back and I dose that with some of that chemical that I use in my video, chemically welding PLA and PETG. And I'm hoping that that will go in between any layers that aren't real tight and make it a little stronger. I put it all together. I have everything lubricated with lots of corn oil. And this thing is still kind of creaking and making noise, but it's moving pretty well. I'll let that run in for several hours. And then I'll take the bird and the base, I'll separate them. I have a laundry tub, and I'll put some dishwashing detergent with warm water, and I'll slosh it back and forth, and then rinse it to get the excess oil off of there. Because if you don't, it's just going to be a dust catcher. And if the oil attracts a bunch of dirt, this won't be running very smoothly. So it's a work in progress. I don't have the tail on there yet, but the tail is gravity operated anyway.